Yeah, she's all bolted up now. Oh, she's free, which is good. These tops back on. We're gonna give it a wee run, see if it's going right. Aye, they are only
from. They only come out to the top. Pay them. See that? They only come out to the top. Aye, that. Yeah, I tell you what, there could be a bit of grass or something underneath that, not letting it up.
Right, this here's our plate that we got made up. This here's the old bit. We need to take this hanger off it here. It's a wee bit thicker, this new stuff. It's a fair old thickness stuff, but the important bit is that she's folded near enough. Perfect. We there's just a wee bar on that at the corner.
Ah, well, that's alright, we can get that.
Pushed in.
What are you doing, Dad?
That looks like it'd be close enough, but it's not cleaned in the right spot.
Yeah.
We're under the moor here. So we put the plate in this morning and it's a bit thicker stuff, it's maybe a mill or two thicker. So whenever you push it right up to the top there, it's catching on this toe, the big one coming along the bottom. It's catching just on it, because it says just a wee bit more than your hanger. So we'll have to nick a wee bit off the edge of the hanger too, to allow for the extra thickness. So they're just cutting the wee chunk out for to get around that, and then we'll see how much we need to slice off the hanger. So plate looks good, it's very good fit. So, the fold is just tiny wee bit different, but it seems to be enough. Well, we think the fold up and then down, so it goes. Then it comes along here and it goes up and then down. So I think that this up bit is to flow the grass up here, when your conditioner is going up this way. Show you how dirty it is. The conditioner is spinning this way to fluff up your grass, and then your grass ends up out here in your row out behind you. So your disc spin here cuts the grass, comes along the back plate, flicks it up here to the conditioner. Conditioner flings it out, so the wee lip is just, we think that's what it's for. So we're cutting it here now in the other shed, so we have to do it on both sides because it'd be the same. It'll be resting then on this whenever the hanger's in place here, it'll be resting on that. So cut the same chunk out on both sides. Sit it in. See, do we need any out of the hanger itself?
Right.
Like, you're talking, you have a brave bit to take off this, like. This isn't just taking off the tip of it, it's taking a cut off the whole angle.
Yeah, pen.
New marker from there, you can. Straight through the middle of the line.
Right, okay.
Straight through the middle, if you can.
Hold on, we have to take these here.
She's too long anyway.
Right.
So if you take your wee nick out of it.
Yes.
Your wee corner.
Yeah.
And then see.
Would it let it in a bit?
Oh, it will, yeah.
Well, you'll have to come a wee bit off this end too whenever you get it lined
up. Yeah, but you would need to get it in a wee bit closer, wouldn't you?
You need to have it in a bit closer before you...
Let's see here, John, just to see. Can you let that all go up any higher?
Well, you'd have to lift the plate.
Yeah, well, I...
But you don't want to take too big of a square out or you'll not be able to... There'll not be much to weld to. Yeah, we have the plate in. These two are lined up. So number two goes here, number two slot. He lines up. There's no gap along the top, and there's enough to get welded there. And along here too. And number one, he goes in down here. Up and twist. And he, no gap along the top, and she all goes in okay. Real quickly. This one over here is all lined up. Didn't have to take him off. Plate's all sitting level. And then the fourth one's just getting cleaned in there. Yeah, so that we can mark him up. See, do we need to cut the wee end off him just to line him up? Spot on. Just took them discs off because the man came last night for luck. See, can he do this? He can. He's going to do it some wet evening, whenever. There's lines drew onto it, so we can weld them out here first. And then underneath, they just need a wee tack along one side. So, just get them off so they can get in at the back to tack on this plate whenever it's faced up against it. So we might have to screw up the arms in case he needs it lifted, but that's not a huge job. So I'll see you whenever we're back at this. So I'll just show you the welds. Stuck it off, nice looking weld. That there, that was just a wee tack, and there's a big bead there. Sure, another one there, and then underneath we're going here. She's welded on there. She's welded there. Same there on that one. They're all welded both sides now on the bottom along there. Right, just change some blades around. We need to tighten them up to whatever it says in the book. Says 120 newton meters. See that there? So that's what we take. Now we're just going to take it down the field. We're just washing the cattle trailer out. So we're just going to take it down the field, give her a wee run, see if she sounds okay. You'll not really know until she goes into the crop of grass, like, but we'll have to find that one out next year. Hopefully, it's a good result. Right, so that's it for today's video. We got the moor all back together. Give it a quick run down the field and she sounded okay, but I mean, we'll have to wait till she goes into the grass to see does it actually work well. We're gonna get this tractor sent away to the mechanic because there's a squeaky fan belt and we might get him just to have a look over it and see if everything's all right with it, because whenever we first got it, it was fit to run the moor all right, so. It was struggling the last couple of years, so there must be something just not 100% either with the mower or the tractor. But we got new plate in the back of the mower, we put new tine in it, and we had to change knives because whenever it ripped lumps of steel out of it whenever they were cutting this year, it damaged loads of knives. So we got the knives changed too, and it's all back together. Fingers crossed we'll be able to cut our own silage next year. But hit the subscribe button, ring the little bell, and you'll get a notification of that video whenever it comes out. And if you did enjoy the video, please hit like, because it helps push the video to other people. So that's it for today's video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.